going on, guys? Good morning. So today we are jumping right into it. We're gonna head over to my managed aircraft, which is the Gulfstream G280. The guys are wrapping up some of the maintenance that we have left on the aircraft, so we should be done soon. Hopefully we're done today, because tomorrow the plane has a scheduled detailing. We're gonna be detailing the plane on the outside, the landing gear, the whole exterior of the plane. It's pretty dirty, and the interior. Hopefully by the time I get there, the guys are pretty far ahead and we won't have much to do, because we actually have to break away at around 1 o'clock and head over to Orlando Executive. So I had weekly work on another plane that we have waiting for us over there. So it's been an eventful day. So from the last video, as you guys may remember, if you've seen it, if you haven't seen it, go to my channel and you'll see a more in-depth explanation of this problem. So we had an issue where on the main screens, we had no input for our camera. As you can see now, this aircraft comes with a tail camera. We now have footage coming through. What was the problem? As you can see here on this monitor, we have tail view camera, we have the tail view camera, and the biggest of all, this monitor is working again. And we also have the tail view camera right there. Sorry. So the issue that we had, based on the troubleshooting that we did, was that this node right here, it's a AVDS box. What it does is that it receives information and it distributes it to different areas of the aircraft. So in this box, you receive data from the camera, you receive data from the cabin display unit, you receive data from the Blu-ray, the DVD player, you receive data from a lot of things. That box was, it overheated and it failed internally. So when we checked it on our system, which is our client portal was letting us know, which I'll show you guys in the video now, our client portal was showing us that node number 3 was offline. It didn't matter what configuration we did. We also realized that the software was also outdated. The program that keeps the system and communicates with it was also extremely outdated. We're cleaning that up. We're making sure that the aircraft is fully updated and it's at its latest software. We get service bulletins, you know, where it lets us know that for matters like this, there are programs that we need to update from time to time, because as these planes continue to fly and operate, systems upgrade, systems change, and we're able to do firmware upgrades or software upgrades where it'll bring everything current. You know, we were behind like 16 revisions, which is insane, but it happens. So long story short, we changed the box, we configured the box, we made sure that everything was current with everything else. But unfortunately, even though we had the cabin working now, the cabin screens and everything operating how it needs to, as you can see the feed here, we do not have any feed in the cockpit. And I'll show you. So in the cockpit, we're gonna select DCU number 2, we're video, we're gonna select tail, and right now, this is what we get. Green, no video input. This is what we're getting in the cockpit. What's happening is that there's another box. So this aircraft comes with 3. You have node number 3, which is this one right here. Then you have node 2, which is the other one in here, that one right there. And then you have node number 1. As you can see, I have a fan in here. That is node number 1. So what's going on with node 1 is that these fans potentially are shorting and they're failing. Those fans are not cooling how they need to, where we cannot see any communication in our client portal. You'll be able to see in a second what I'm talking about. So initially we had one failure. Connect. Another node. We'll let this do its thing. It's gonna upload now. So right now it's connecting. We're supposed to have 3 green, right? So right now we have 3 green. But what happens with time is, as you, there you go, it just did it. So node number 1, which is the one in the closet, will start to flash. And as it's turning yellow, the screen is also going crazy. But long story short, this box fixed the majority of the problems, which is gonna keep the owner happy. He can see his monitor again. He can see the tail camera view again. Unfortunately, in the cockpit, we have no video footage there, but the crew is also not really too concerned about that. So even though they're not concerned about it, we still have an electrical component that's failing, and that is a risk. That's a hazard because this can overheat, it can short, it can melt, and we don't want to wait for that. So hoping that we'll have another 5 days around there, 6 days down, where we can send that box out for repair. And as we're doing that, if you guys can see, the camera view is not really the clearest. It looks a little dirty, spotty. And what's happening is that when the plane flies, a camera gets filled with condensation. So we're gonna send out the camera to get repaired as well. We're gonna take advantage of the priority of the camera because the camera has to get done as soon as possible. The plane is gonna be down for at least 6 days. We'll be able to send out that box in the closet to get it repaired. Then we'll reinstall it. And hopefully when we install, which we'll have our view in the cockpit and we will no longer have a node box that is overheating. With that being said, guys, we finally got the cabin repaired. I'm very happy with the results. The owner's gonna be extremely happy, and we're good to go. So we're just gonna wrap it up. We're gonna reinstall all the components that we removed. We'll be back later on today, and we're going to install this side panel that's here. So this side panel is what covers everything on that sidewall. Wrap this plane up, and then tomorrow it's gonna get detailed, and the owner will be able to make his flights. So with that being said, stay tuned, guys. We're gonna head over there in a little bit. I'm gonna shut down everything on this plane, and we'll go check on the guys, see what we got going on. And that's a wrap. We'll be feeling the rest of the stuff later when we come back. Gotta scrape up the bottom of that panel. All right, guys, well, we will be back later on today to install that side panel, like I said, and we'll check you guys out later. All right, guys, we are here at the Global 5000. As you can see right behind me, the lower cowl is opened up. The guys were working on changing the fuel cooling filter. They're getting ready to do a wet spool, so we're not gonna turn on the engine. We're just gonna prime it, and we're gonna leak check the housing that they removed the filter from. That capsule right there, you remove that cover, and underneath that is your filter. Really simple task. Remove the hardware, change out your filter, install the new one. We'll wet spool it, leak check it, make sure everything is good to go. Give her a quick little wipe down. You can see some residual oil here, which is very common.
Show you guys how this Global 5000 looks.
Quick little preview. Doing a walk around, and I noticed this. I'm gonna see if I can tuck this back in here for them. This is the main cabin here. Look at how beautiful and wide this one is. We got plenty of seating. Very, very spacious. And you have your own flight attendant seat here. In these older planes, these things take a crap and they go bad. The tracks start to get stuck. There really isn't much you can do to it, but you can put a little bit of lube in it, make it a little bit better, just a little bit better. Here you have a forward lav. This is a full lav. The Gulfstream that you guys saw before, you were only able to see, it only had a toilet. This one has a sink with a toilet, all the neat little things. This is a cockpit here. Pretty good day. Got some really good progress on our G280. We got this Global 5000 that we're working on right now. Can't complain, can't complain. Really grateful. Hopefully work continues to pick up for our guys, especially as we're expanding, we're hiring more manpower. So things will start turning pretty good soon.